Now double Gurston champion Steve Butts waits for the green light. This is Steve's first appearance this year in his own lightweight, fully aerodynamic Lotus Elise, and he has his sights set on a third championship title. In 2005, he beat longtime Gurston sponsor Jonathan Gates to the crown by a hundredth of a point. The following year, Gates turned the tables on him by that same tiny margin. Back in April, in a borrowed car, Butts didn't make the top 10 scorers, but today, in his own Elise, he looks on course to make the championship leaderboard. It's a typically clean, fast run from the former double champion and a new class record, which puts him right up into the championship top six. Back in the paddock, Steve talked to Tony Wiltshire.
Steve has a great track record in the Gurston Hillclimb Championship, having won it in 2004, 2005 in this very car. Steve, that means a lot of continuous development must have gone on to keep improving your times as you do.
Yeah, I've put quite a lot of time in, but I've got a lot of help from people as well, like Steve Guglielmi for the setup and handling, and Dave Andrews for the engine building, and also Murray Harrison Racing for the most recent engine build. It's not just me.
Well, it's you driving the car, and there's some spectacular times coming out of it. To have taken a whole 0.4 of a second off your own record in one run, pretty spectacular. Do you know where that time came from?
It's still under my personal best. I've just got to focus on what I did in 2005, where I did a 33.1, and not make any mistakes. Just do that perfect linked up run.
For the first round here, you were using a borrowed car. That clearly gave you a little bit of a handicap, but we know that you can drop one score from this championship throughout the season. So with some consistency, that puts you in a competitive position, doesn't it?
Yeah, hopefully I'll be able to keep Jim White honest and pray for some sun at every meeting.
Castle Carey firefighter Ben Stapley is something of a permanent fixture at Gurston Down and always provides good entertainment in his 3-litre straight six fuel injected Datsun 240Z. Just 0.08 of a second improvement would give him the class lead from Steve Holly's TVR Griffith, but that looks like a big brake balance problem into Carousel. As the Datsun locks up the near side rear and spins into the infield, Ben's challenge to the TVR has evaporated. It's hard to believe that the E-Type Jaguar has been around for almost 50 years, and it's great to see them still competing in motorsport, where once they swept all before them. Once very popular for sprint and hill climb work, there aren't too many about these days. Paul Slay's E-Type is a superbly prepared version of the 3.8-litre fixed-head coupe and a regular visitor to Gurston. Doesn't hang about either. Slade hurls a big car through Carousel as he closes in on the Porsche 911s of Brian Hunt and Peter Turnbull. The three cars are covered by a pocket handkerchief at the end, and Paul is less than a second adrift of class winner Steve Holly. Jim White is just a hundredth of a point behind championship leader Mike Rudge and has his sights set firmly on Andrew Semmons' class record. If Jim can break the record, he'll take the championship lead in his more-speed BMW-headed Mini. We'll be featuring this unique machine in the next programme, but right now, let's watch White's phenomenal pace. Down the box and into Carousel, he holds the long first gear right up through Ashes. Semmons' record has stood for 8 years and stands at 36.80. White has just a couple of hundred yards to go now. Can he do it? Yes, he certainly can, and with a whole half second to spare.
After round one, Jim White was second in the championship with a 0.01 of a second deficit to Mike Rudge. This afternoon, Jim has gone below his own record by a massive 0.51 of a second and now has a comfortable lead in the championship as it stands. Jim, that was a spectacular time.
Thank you very much.
Where did the time come from?
Well, we had a lot of rain overnight. It's washed the surface nice and clean, and we had good weather this afternoon. And everyone else is going really quick, so I had to pull one out of the bag, so just went for it. We had to get the speed through hollow, because usually we go through hollow with a slight lift, but this time it was flat. It was absolutely nailed.
That's a brave call through hollow. I mean, the car must be getting a little bit loose through there.
Yeah, the back end's just starting to float, but you've got to stick on the throttle to get that front end biting and pulling it on rein.
That's a tricky corner, but quite high speed. What sort of speed do you think you're achieving around there?
Probably exiting around about 90, I would have thought.
Yeah, that's going some.
The trouble is trying to get it nice and steady to brake before the right-hander.
Get the car settled for carousel.
It squirms around a lot, but it's good fun.
Well, certainly from the in-car stuff, we know you wrestle the car quite well, so... Excellent time, as you said, Jim.
You
must be biting your fingernails now, seeing what your competitors are doing as well.
Yeah. It's going to be an interesting season, I think.
Absolutely, yeah. Especially when drop scores come into play as well.
Yeah, I'll keep everyone honest.
That's the attitude. Well done, Jim.
Thank you very much.
Have a good afternoon.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Well, Subaru Impreza has certainly made its mark in rallying, and in recent years it's proved a very popular sprint and hill climb car too. Adrian Flagg first came to Gurston a year or so ago, and he's been rapidly making his own mark on the large capacity modified saloon car class. This year he's been sharing the car with his father David, and in a moment Tanya will be talking to them both. Now though, Adrian's really pushing on in the Impreza and intent on toppling Colin Smith and the Escort Cosworth off the class lead. The time to beat is 35.20, and another smooth, rapid drive from the Christchurch driver could just do the trick. 35.28, it's a personal best, but just 900 shy of the win. Back now to Tony in the paddock.
We're here with father and son team, Adrian and David Flagg. Adrian has just taken a personal best and managed second in class. Good run for you, Adrian?
Yeah, very good. Personal best. Weather's been good today, so could have gone a bit faster, I think, but there's always next time.
Absolutely. The important thing is to have a car in one piece for next time.
It. I did have an off yesterday, which luckily didn't damage it, but just filled it up with grass.
tends to make you focus, that, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Now, we don't have too many medallion men in speed hill climbing, but you've got a fairly impressive one here, David. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, a month ago I was elected as the His Worshipful the Mayor of the ancient borough of Christchurch. So I don't know, I'm probably the first mayor to run up the hill, I'm sure.
That's certainly an interesting distraction from hill climbing, no doubt about that. Are you going to use motorsport and that position to sort of form any link?
I hope to have a motorsport stroke road safety day next year. It's going to take some organising, but Andrew today has very kindly donated a day at the Hill Climb School, which was absolutely fantastic. So, and hope to get the Dorset Police involved with their rally car, but yet to ask them yet, but I'm sure that they'll oblige.
Well, great to see sort of motorsport and local authorities joining up together and promoting something really worthwhile in the community.
Absolutely. If it benefits and tries to make the youngsters more aware of road safety, then that's what it's all about, and bring them into the motorsport at club level.
Absolutely. Well, guys, thanks very much for your time. Have a great season. Best of luck.
Thanks very much.
Simon Marsh on the line now in his Clubman's Mallet with 1700cc crossflow Ford power. The name Marsh might seem familiar, and in fact Simon is one of the three motorsporting sons of six times British champion Tony Marsh, who we saw earlier in the programme. Simon returned to hill climbing a couple of years ago in this Mark 18, always regarded as one of the best of the front engine Clubman chassis built in Northamptonshire by the legendary Arthur Mallock and his sons Richard and Raymond. Following work by Tom New at New Techniques, Simon's had a lot of success recently with his ex-Tony Brown chassis, and as you'd expect from his ancestry, this is another polished run. 33.05 and another class win for Simon. Keith Diggle's WEV always draws the crowds in the paddock, not least because of its superb standard of preparation. It's quick too, and the former 1200 Formula Circuit car now runs a 2-litre Cosworth BDG, built to the same immaculate standard by the owner. Diggle is clearly the man to beat in the 2-litre Sport Super class today, and he's already 5 seconds clear of the opposition. Through carousel he doesn't put a foot wrong, and out of ashes he howls over Burke's Rise to record a personal best within 3/4 of a second of Ed Hollier's class record. It's 30.42 and a comfortable class win. On the line now, the man with everything to do on his final run of the day. Defending champion Mike Runge must break his class record if he's to retrieve his championship lead from Jim White. He's giving it everything as he launches the Westfield off the line and down into Hollow. It's a perfect line, just brushing the curb as he hurls the car through on full power. Flat through the long left, he leaves his braking as late as he dares, but once again he locks up an outside wheel. Shrugging off the mistake, Mike throws the car into carousel and clips the curb. He must get Ashes right. He exits with a rapidly corrected tail slide, buries the throttle and attacks Burke's Rise. It's a tall order. He needs at least a 30.52 to take the championship lead, but it's not to be. So after round two of this four-round series, it's Jim White and the record-breaking Mini that snatches the lead from defending champion Mike Rudge's Westfield. Coming up on the rails is Andy Bascom in the Escort Warrior, while in another Mini, Neil Masters hangs on to fourth place. Breathing down his neck, Anthony Orchard's Westfield Mega Booster is coming under pressure from former champion Steve Butts. Join us next time for more high-speed hill climb action from Wiltshire.